In 10 seasons of Survivor, no player had dominated a single season quite like the winner of Palau. G'day guys, welcome back to Snuffle, where we discuss everything about the greatest game on television, Survivor. Today we'll be revisiting Survivor Palau as we take a look back at Tom Westman's journey to the title of Sole Survivor. Survivor Palau first introduced us to Tom Westman, a 40-year-old New York City firefighter as a member of the Karor tribe alongside Ian Rosenberger, a dolphin trainer from Ambridge, Pennsylvania, 29-year-old advertising executive Katie Gallagher, and Jen Lyon, a 32-year-old nanny from California. When the castaways arrived, it was revealed that they would be living together for the first night, and Tom immediately aligned himself with Ian, Katie, and Stephanie LaGrossa. The following day, the tribes were formed by a schoolyard pick, and Tom was selected by Katie to join Karor. He went on to pick Janu, and Karor won the first immunity challenge, opting to only take the fire-making kit, which played to their advantage as Oolong focused on taking as much as possible. The high from winning immunity didn't last long as Karor capsized on their way back to camp, losing their fire-making kit.
We were so elated, the ride back in the canoe was just, we were just loving life and couldn't wait to see the new beach and all this to happen. We're just crushed right now and we don't have the water. We don't have the flint to start a fire, to boil the water and purify it. We lost everything we won today. We're in a worse scenario than we originally had.
Tom emerged as the leader of Karor and led his tribe to 4 consecutive immunity wins, allowing his alliance with Ian, Katie, Greg and Jen to form, leaving Karen, Kobe, Janu and Willard on the outs. Tom began to clash with Willard due to his lack of work ethic around camp, so when the tribe were finally forced to vote out one of their own in a double tribal council, Willard was eliminated as the tribe's weakest member in a unanimous vote.
We made so many hints to Willard about, you know, we all have to help with the fire. Either he's playing a game where he's wearing me down by making me stay up all night, or he's just got the kind of attitude where, why should I do it if somebody else is going to do it for me?
Karor continued to dominate the game until Oolong were whittled down to just one member, with Stephanie joining Karor at the merge. Meanwhile, Kobe and Tom began to come to loggerheads with a battle to lead the tribe brewing between them. Tom honoured his alliance with Stephanie from day one and promised to protect her, and after local fishermen visited the tribe, he reaffirmed his position in the game, much to Kobe's disappointment. Tom was the first to win individual immunity and rallied to eliminate Kobe, taking his biggest adversary out of the game. Janu became the next enemy after she helped herself to leftovers meant for the others after returning from a traditional feast with locals, and her mind was clearly out of the game. Tom won individual immunity for the second time in a row and began to plot to eliminate Stephanie, viewing her as a threat due to her competitive spirit. However, these plans were halted by Janu quitting, leaving an angry Stephanie back at camp.
From day two, Katie, Ian, myself, and Stephanie had all decided that we'd try to run this as a final four. And we all agreed that should we get split into different tribes, every man for himself, but look out for each other when we do get back together. The problem with that right now is Jen and Greg, who have since joined Ian, Katie, and I and have become 5, are adamant that Stephanie goes home.
Tom tried to calm Stephanie, but knew that it was the safest option to eliminate her. After Karen told him that Stephanie had proposed an all-women's alliance, Tom led the tribe in unanimously voting out Stephanie and in the process, eliminating his biggest threat. Tom had full control of the game with only 6 remaining, but to ensure his position at the end, he had to break up the power couple of Greg and Jen, encouraging Karen to pretend she was the next to go, in order to throw Greg off the scent of a potential blindside. He joined Ian, Katie and Karen in blindsiding Greg. Before the reward challenge, Tom told Ian to pick a woman to join him if he won reward to prevent a women's alliance from forming. However, Ian won reward and asked Tom to join him. They did manage to persuade Katie to stay loyal to them, and Tom won individual immunity once again at the final 5, eliminating Karen after she exposed his power position. Tom continued on his immunity streak, winning at the final 4, where he forced Ian to make fire against Jen, as he felt betrayed by Ian for not remaining loyal to the alliance and plotting against him. The final 3 competed in the final immunity challenge and battled out for hours, until eventually Ian was overcome by guilt for betraying Tom and stepped out of the challenge, telling him to take Katie instead, and that his friendship was more important to him than $1 million. Tom respected this move by Ian, gifting individual immunity to Tom and securing his place at Final Tribal Council with Katie. Katie was criticised by the jury and Tom didn't escape the heat either, being criticised by Kobe for playing a dirty game and Stephanie for not honouring their alliance and protecting her. Tom remained honest throughout the game and told the jury, "You met the real Tom Westman, good or bad?" He dominated the game from beginning to end, winning in a 6-1 vote over Katie Gallagher to become the oldest winner up to this point in the show's history after being crowned the sole survivor.
the winner of Survivor Palau.
Tom entered Survivor Palau as a hero, immediately forming close bonds with Ian, Katie and Stephanie, and he left the game as a legend. He successfully navigated his way from day 1 to day 39 with ease, showing it's possible to dominate the game of Survivor. At the time, he was considered to be among the best to ever play, and with his dominant physical, social and strategic gameplay, it's easy to see why. What did you think of Tom Westman's journey to the title of Soul Survivor? Let us know in the comment section down below. If you enjoy what you've seen, I'd really appreciate it if you give me a like and consider subscribing to the channel for all the fixins. New videos just like this one every Tuesday and Thursday, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's Wednesday and Friday, Australian time. Stay tuned next week as we look at Danny Boatwright, the winner of Survivor Guatemala. Heroic yet strategic. Survivor shows your true character. No matter how nice you are on the outside, you still have to betray and backstab to get to the end. Grab your torches, head back to camp. Good night.
The cat's out of the bag said, I'm a strong player and I'm fit and I'm not the old guy in the tribe.
I would say the butcher wrapped it, huh? With a little butcher string and stuff.
You can't go back and now pretend that you're less than you are or that you're, you know, don't have capabilities. It's kind of done.
Unbelievable.
That's good.
Here, I'm grabbing it.